Hello there, and thank you very much for joining us in this new Azure Portal how-to video. Today, we'll learn how to find and use the Translator service in the Azure Portal. And we have Eric Wiener with us that is going to show us how to do that. So thank you very much for joining us today, Eric.
Thanks, Leon. Yeah, today we're going to focus on the Translator service and how you can find it, understand what it does, and get some sample code for your application. And along the way, I'm going to show you how you can then even learn about the other exciting cognitive services and applied AI services in Azure.
That sounds awesome. Let's do it.
Okay, Leon, so here we are in the Azure portal, and I'm going to show you how you can find the Translator service and the other cognitive services. Here in the All Services experience, we do have filtering here, so you can find a service by filtering for its name. And in the Applied AI and Machine Learning area, you can see we have all of the rich capabilities of cognitive services and Applied AI all published here under the name of the service, like language. We saw vision. And here's Translator. And from here in one click, I can create or view the translators in my environment and easily access the Translator service. Let me show you yet another way. The top level search here in the portal is very popular with customers and is a spot where you can do freeform searching, and the results are brought right here in front of you. And so here you can see when I begin to search for Translator, the service is the top match, and I can click through and navigate directly to the Translator service. This is our default view of the translator. You can see I don't have any in my environment today, but I can go ahead and create them from here, and it'll get me directly in there. In addition to that, the same set of services you saw in All Services are offered here on the left side for easy navigation amongst the cognitive services capabilities. And before I create, let me just show you the overview page here in the cognitive services area, which offers even more information so that you can be sure, is it the translator service you're looking for or something else? This is another area where we explain the cognitive services collection and how it can help you in your application, as well as categorizing the services and showing within each card the function of the service and quick access to the create and the view functions per service. Here you can see we explain vision. The vision service is for analyzing content in images and videos. This translator service that we're going to work through just in a second shows you how it can detect and translate languages. But I do want to show you this landing page can also keep you up to date. As we develop more new cognitive services, we can put flags here for that. And also we can offer guidance on the Applied AI service collection that you can also see. And again, we took a similar approach here where we explain what each service does, offering you even more guidance to find just the service you're looking for. Let's go back to cognitive services, and we're going to get started creating that translator service. This is the create screen for the translator service. And with just a few clicks, I pick my resource group, which helps me organize my Azure resources. I pick the region I want it to run in. Here I'll choose global. I give it a name, which I'll then use as a reference from my application when I need to interact with this translator's instance. And choose the pricing tier. And you can see there's a variety of options here. I'm going to pick the free one since I'm just trying this service out. I'm going to jump to the end here. That's all I need to do. And then once we've validated my entries, I'm going to go ahead and create this translator instance. At this point, we're now creating the instance that's going to be in my subscription in my resource group for use by my application. And it's complete. So let's jump to the resource and try it out. Let's have a look at see what the translator service can do. Here on the homepage, you can see there's a demo built directly into this experience that lets me interact with my translator service. And just by typing a few words here in this left side box, we send that string to the server and we get back the results here. We've chosen to get the results back in Spanish. And you can see just how quick the service is, and it keeps up with my typing, and I can then decide this is exactly the kind of function that I want to add to my application so that I can translate the various strings into the user's language. Below this demo box, we offer the request that we push out on the wire, and as well as the response. So as a developer, I can get comfortable with These are the data structures I'm going to be processing in my application, and they look pretty simple. And I can even here change languages. So if I switch it over to French and want to see how that capability works, I could switch it to French, type a little more text, and just as quick as it was for Spanish, here it is doing a translation into French. So that's pretty cool. I'm pretty happy with how this works with the data structures. So the next thing I'm going to need is some sample code to go with my application. And that's offered directly here as well. Switching to sample code, I can see in a variety of languages here, C#, Node, Python. I can copy this sample code. I can navigate to where it's stored on GitHub and pretty easily take this sample code and adapt it into my application so that my application can leverage the translator service and add that capability to my application.
Thank you very much, Eric. This was great and very simple. Please try this out. Let us know what you think. Leave us a comment in the comment section. Also, we have more than 60 videos showing other scenarios that are super simple as well that we would love you to try and leave us a comment as well. So thank you very much for watching. See you in the next video. Bye for now.